Hello everyone, my name is Renika and today we are going to learn about class 9 topic and the topic is circles. Okay, so we are going to learn one theorem. You can see theorem is already written in my board. The theorem is the perpendicular from the center of a circle to a chord bisects the chord. Okay, so that is the theorem we have to prove. So first you have to write the theorem like this. After that, you have to write the given statement. Okay, what is given here? The perpendicular from the center of a circle. So, before writing the given statement, we are going to make a diagram. So, the diagram is this is a circle, and O is the center of a circle. PQ is a chord, OL is the perpendicular that is drawn from the center. So, what is the perpendicular? Basically, perpendicular is that line that is making a 90 degree angle here. So, if it is making 90 degrees, so that means this angle also 90 degrees. Okay? So, that is the perpendicular. So, we have written the given. O is the center of a circle. PQ is a chord. ON is perpendicular drawn from the center. That's the second one. Okay? Now, what to prove? Means what we have to prove. Okay? So, what we have to prove for finding this, you have to read this statement twice. Okay? The perpendicular from the center of a circle to a chord bisects the chord. Okay, so that is the thing that we have to do. That is the main part. Okay, that we have to do. Understood? So what we have to do, we have to prove bisects the chord. That means OL is the perpendicular and L is the point where OL is meeting with the PQ. So we have to prove PL equal to HQ. Bisecting means it is dividing the line in two equal parts. PL equal to LQ. Understood? Okay. So to prove in the two proof, what we are going to write? PL equal to LQ. Okay, now how can we do that? Okay. For this, you can see it is like OL and PL and HQ. Lastly, I am going to find out how can we start. Okay, so I am doing one construction. I am doing one construction. I am joining this OP and this OP. Okay, so in the construction, what you have to write? Join OP and OP. Okay, you have to write join OP and OP. Okay. So, when you are joining OP and OQ, so what is this? OP is the radius, OQ is also the radius. Okay? Why it is the radius? Because we are joining P is the point that is in the circumference of the circle and Q is also the point that is in the circumference of the circle. Okay? So, that's why OP and OQ. Okay. Now, just see this figure. Okay? Now, we can find one option. How can we prove that? We have to prove PL equal to LQ. So, you can see there are two triangles. One is OLP and second is OLQ. Okay. One is OLP and the second one is OLQ. And this time, we can, we already know. Okay. We already know the congruence. Okay. Because we already completed the congruence part in the previous chapter of the circle. Okay. So, we are going to use the congruence here. If we are taking two triangles, OLQ and OLP. OLQ and OLP. So, I am writing the solution here. What you have to write? You have to write in triangle OLP and triangle OLQ. Okay? In triangle OLP and triangle OLQ, in triangle OLP and OLQ, what are the same thing? Like OP equal to OQ because radius of the circle is like the okay. Now, what we have to write? The angles are also same. Okay, so you can write angle OLP. Angle OLP equal to angle OLQ equal to 90 degrees. That means both are same. and the second, the last part is OL equal to OM. Okay. So now we got the three things. Okay. Now what is the congruence? Which congruence we can apply here? Like SAS, SSS, RHS. Okay, many, many congruences are here. So let's find out. You can see here the 90 degree angle and PO. PO is the hypotenuse and PL is the base. Okay. So can we right angle, hypotenuse, and side? Okay. Right angle, this is the right angle that we are using. And OL equal to OL is the side. And OP equal to OQ is the hypotenuse. Okay. So that will OP equal to OQ, that is the hypotenuse. OLP and OLQ, that is the right angle. And OL equal to OL, that is the side. Okay. Can we use this? So we can use that. Okay. We are writing OLP equal to, you have to make the congruence sign, OL. RHS. Okay. We are using RHS. Okay. So OLP equal to OLQ. We already proved this. Now, with the CPCT, I am writing here. Okay. With the CPCT, CPCT means like common parts. Okay. So, with the CPCT, we can do PL equal to LQ. We can write, not we cannot prove, we can write, okay, with the CPCT. Okay, so PL equal to LQ, that we have to prove, now it's done. Okay, so after that, just you have to write sine square. Okay, I hope you understand the theorem. Okay, and thank you very much. Bye.